U.S. military officials have identified a Marine who died Saturday in Iraq. 35-year-old Gunnery Sergeant Scott Koppenhafer of Colorado died during combat operations in the Nineveh province. According to the Wall Street Journal, the Defense Department is investigating if he was killed by friendly fire. Koppenhafer is survived by his wife and two children. Workers in Paris, France are preparing to decontaminate some of the streets around Notre Dame Cathedral. They tested with high levels of lead following the April blaze that damaged the landmark Catholic church. Cleanup work inside the cathedral will resume next week. It had been suspended last month for safety reasons. Hong Kong's airport has canceled all departed flights for the second day after protesters took over the terminals. The airport's arrival and departure halls were blocked by thousands of demonstrators. They're calling for democratic reforms and an independent inquiry into alleged police brutality. Many Hong Kong residents see an increasing erosion of the freedoms they were promised in 1997 when Communist China took over the former British colony. Father Bernardo Cervellera is the editor-in-chief of Asia News, an agency that covers the Catholic Church in Asia. Father, there are nearly 400,000 Catholics in Hong Kong out of a population of nearly 7 million. How are Catholics involved in the pro-democracy movement?
The Catholic youth are totally involved in the movement for the elimination of the extradition law. Perhaps the older people a little bit less, because they fear a little bit these aspects of violences by extremists during the demonstrations. But the church, and above all the auxiliary bishop Joseph Fa, has done many, many vigils with the youth asking for this law to be cancelled. And secondly, also the administrator, the apostolic administrator of the Hong Kong diocese, who is the Cardinal John Tong, said and asked the government to eliminate this extradition law, and also asked for an independent inquiry about the excessive use of force for the police. And these two requests are the main requests of the movement who is doing all these demonstrations in Hong Kong.
Hong Kong is a former British colony that was returned to China in 1997 under the framework of one country, two systems. Do you think, Father, that China has respected the agreement?
Oh, no, not at all. Since the beginning of the so-called Hui Guo, the return of Hong Kong to the mother, to the fatherland, the Chinese government started to influence the politics. They refused to give and to make steps for full democracy in the territory. They tried to control also the education system in Hong Kong, and it has a big influence of the economy in Hong Kong. In these days, for example, many entrepreneurs who were sympathetic towards the movement anti-extradition, now they are making some steps back because China menaced them to destroy their business.
Well, we know the Catholic Church in mainland China is under great pressure, despite a deal with the Vatican. Can you give us an idea of what the situation with the church is like in Hong Kong? Do people have the freedom of worship there?
In Hong Kong, there is total freedom of worship and also total freedom of evangelization, because up to now, and for at least for 50 years, nothing should change in Hong Kong. So the freedom that the church in Hong Kong is enjoying is a freedom as a liberal society. So they can have evangelization, they can have education, they can have priests and decision of the diocese without any control by the government. Our fear is that if this extradition law goes into effects, this could destroy the possibility for priests in Hong Kong, faithful in Hong Kong, who can help the church in China, because in this way, the help brought by the Catholics in Hong Kong to China could be considered as a criminal case.
Very interesting. Well, we'll continue to follow all this and see how it continues to play out. And certainly we'll be watching carefully to see how this affects Catholics in the region. Father Bernardo Cervellera, Editor-in-Chief of Asia News, thanks very much for talking with us today.
Thanks to you.